So I don't know about you guys or anyone watching this video, but for me, when I'm reviewing cars, honestly, the thing that I look for the most is just the overall feeling. It's not necessarily a nominal feature of the car. It's not something you can grade on a scale, really. And you guys know, if you've been subscribers to my channel, I don't really do grades for cars after I've driven them, just because when doing a review, typically, to be quite honest with you, you don't have enough time behind the wheel to really get, I feel as though, like an accurate, score for X, Y, and Z. But for me, when I'm looking at a car and when I want to buy a car, put my hard-earned money towards something, I want to be able to enjoy it. Now, yes, for those of you that have families out there or are, blue-collar workers, contractors, whatever, there's other factors that come into something, especially that you're going to be daily driving. But honestly, I think that when it comes to car enthusiast vehicles, a lot of people just look for what they like, what they want, and just what they enjoy most when they're actually behind the wheel of the vehicle. Now, the car that I'm going to be talking about today in the title of this video may be a little bit controversial to some, but also, before we even get into it, let me know down in the comments below what you would consider to be a modern car versus a classic, or when do you think we should start referring to something as a classic? Because honestly, the car that we're going to be talking about today, I could definitely see it in both of those categories. I could see it being a classic car. I think I would probably refer to it as a classic car. I simply am going to title this video, like the best modern American muscle car, because it's not something like a Cuda, it's not something like a, Shelby Cobra, a 69 Mustang, something like that, like something from the 60s or 70s. It's a little bit more modern than that. But when it comes to overall driving experience, there's pretty much nothing that can compare to this vehicle. Now, before we even get into it, definitely be sure to like, comment, subscribe, all that stuff if you guys are new here. It definitely helps me out a lot as a kind of lower YouTuber, I guess you could say, in today's modern YouTube standards. But today we're going to be talking about the first gen Dodge Viper, specifically the first iteration of that first generation. Now, these Vipers were pretty much bare bones when it comes to a kind of Kelley Blue Book or typical salesperson spiel. There was absolutely no features, nothing that was modern about them. They were just rear-wheel drive, no traction control, didn't even have door handles, and basically had no creature comforts in them whatsoever. However, what they did boast was a 400 plus horsepower, naturally aspirated 8-liter V10. And Dodge actually went ahead and made this basically trying to copy the original Shelby Cobras. They wanted to make a death machine. They wanted to make something that the kind of hardcore muscle car enjoyer will like, will buy and will spend their hard-earned money on. Now, today I was just kind of scrolling through Car and Driver, and they actually have a little section that lists and highlights different bring a trailer auctions that they might see that might interest, I guess, their audience. And we're going to be highlighting that today. That kind of gave me this video idea because honestly, the first generation Dodge Viper was pretty much the last car I can think of, the newest car I can think of that really offered that right off the assembly line. Like, there's no real new cars that just come with absolutely nothing except a shit ton of power and a extremely crazy driving experience, at least off the top of my head. If I'm missing anything, let me know. And I guess you can say that some of the later model Dodge Vipers offered the same experience, and you wouldn't be wrong. They did have the first gen, which originally did come out in 91 and ran all the way to 2002. And there was two different iterations. There was the SR1, which lasted until the 95 model year, and then the SR2 from 96 to 2002. And then you had the second generation, which pretty much lasted from 03 all the way up into 2010. And then the third and final generation from 2013 all the way up to 2017, when Dodge eventually stopped production of that model. Now, yes, you could say a 2017 Dodge Viper ACR is the most badass Dodge Viper you can ever have. And I honestly would agree with you. However, it's not my favorite. My favorite is this first generation Viper, simply because there's not a lot with it. It's just power. You know, you have a removable top, and that's pretty much about it. It's not like you're gonna be driving the thing in rain, so most of the time the top is off anyways. And the example that we're gonna be looking at today is apparently an extremely low mileage example, and it is very clean, but I do say apparently before the mileage, because we'll talk about that in a second. But anyways, here is the article that first brought my attention to it, just from Car and Driver. And essentially they just do a quick kind of overview of it, and you know, it is what it is. It's a beautiful car. Like, it's in black, which if you're gonna have a muscle car, like, that is pretty much the quintessential muscle car exterior color that you would want it in. It has those beautiful kind of like hidden side pipes, not necessarily like the original Shelby Cobra side pipes, because they're not like super exposed, so you're not just gonna burn your ankle on it every time you pop out of the car. But the chrome wheels, which I know a lot of boomers love, I don't really mind chrome wheels. I know some people either love them or hate them. I don't mind them, but the interior looks extremely clean. Doesn't look like there's any tears or anything. And then there's that glorious, beautiful 8-liter naturally aspirated V10. And honestly, naturally aspirated engines, to me, offer such a, I don't want to say better, because who doesn't love forced induction, but just a naturally aspirated engine, even if it's a 4-cylinder or even 3-cylinder, I guess, for some cars, it's just nice, because you press the gas down, there's no single turbo lag. Even some superchargers, like not the belt driven superchargers, some of them have a little bit of kind of unpredictability about them. But anyways, this Car and Driver link kind of does a quick overview of it. And even that steering wheel, like that steering wheel, I'm kind of getting sidetracked right now, but that steering wheel is just so beautiful. And the gauge cluster, you really don't have it. You just got your tach, your speedo, and that's pretty much about it. There's no screen, there's no touch screen like all these modern cars. It does have AC though. That's pretty much the only creature, the AC and a radio. Those are like the only creature comforts that come with this car. But even the steering wheel is just so beautiful. And yes, it's not safe. You can see that clearly, that's a racing steering wheel. There's no airbag fitting in that thing. But anyways, with Car and Driver's overview here, it has a link, and it actually links to the Bring a Trailer listing. Now, if the odd chance that any of you are out there are willing or in the market for a first generation Dodge Viper, this does end in 2 days. I'm gonna be putting up this video tonight. I don't know if it's still gonna be up when you see it, but right now the current bid is only at 32,000 US, which for this car, if you have a garage, forget about the car and the driving experience and all the other great things. I firmly believe that this would be a fantastic investment for any you know, investors or collectors out there, because I definitely have seen, you know, the prices of these first generation Dodge Vipers go up in recent years, and I do not predict them to waver in the coming future. Like, I think they're just going to keep going up and up, especially if you have a one like this. Now, speaking about from a collector standpoint, getting into the mileage and what I said before, apparently this does have 25,000 miles on the odometer. However, if you see right here, so yeah, it says it shows 25,000. However, the Carfax report notes a mileage inconsistency in an April 2014 entry. Now, this is a 1994, so it would have been 20 years at that time, and it's pretty much 30 years right now. And again, that's going back to like the whole modern versus classic. Do you think cars should be considered classic at 30, 20, 40 years even? Now, yes, insurance wise this is a classic, so I guess my title to this video is clickbait, or it's not factual, but in my opinion, like, this is the most recent car that can offer basically the best unwavered kind of driving experience. You just get behind the wheel, it's very simplistic, and you just go and try not to die behind the wheel one of these. Now, going into it, obviously it is a Bring a Trailer listing, so there's plenty of pictures. However, there's no video. There's over 130 pictures, but there's no video, which I do find quite odd, I think, because normally with these you know, websites, you have a lot of collectors and stuff on here that will actually want to hear the car and see the car run. But it's just, it's so beautiful. Like, look at those fat, fat tires on there. I believe the rear tire width was 305s for these first gen Dodge Vipers. I could be wrong. Fact check me down below if you want. But they came with just such meaty, meaty tires. Now, yes, they are all seasons. I'm pretty sure that's, you just have to have that on a factory vehicle to pass, you know, different safety guidelines and stuff. And then you can see the removable soft top. But pretty much no one really drives with that on. I guess that fits in the trunk, and you know, if it rains or if you're caught in the rain, you could throw that on there, but no one's driving with that, especially with these first gens, again, without the exterior door handle. You're pretty much just, you know, top down all the time. And now, one little feature of these first gen Dodge Viper bodies that I absolutely love is this kind of Ram Air little scoop right in the center there. Now the front, yes, the front, the headlights, they're not the most aggressive thing in the world, but if you know anything about cars, you know this is an aggressive damn car. Now yes, if you're not a car person, you might confuse it with an NB Miata, but they're the farthest thing apart in the car world. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. Let me know your opinions on Dodge Vipers, whether you think I'm completely off with my statement and I, you know, you definitely don't think it's the best in a muscle car money could buy. But honestly, for something that's not a special edition, like, I'm not talking about like the Dodge Demon 170 or even the ACR Hellcats or like the GT500. Like, this is pretty much the base model. If you were to go down the line of the Vipers or the special editions that have came out, if you're talking about like a base model Mustang or Camaro, those are the V6 options, or I guess nowadays the turbo inline four options. Same thing with the Chargers and Challengers. For a base model, I guess modern muscle car, this is the best one out there. There's just no competition, at least in my opinion. But again, let me know down in the comments below if you guys think I'm wrong. But anyways, that's pretty much just gonna wrap it up for today's video. I know it was a shorter video, but I'm just kind of trying to get back into the swing of things with a consistent uploading schedule. I'm gonna try to stick to Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays for new videos. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Again, definitely be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe. But like always, I hope you all have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you guys in the next one.